tonight on NewsWatch, protection versus privacy. More on the NSA data leak that has some speaking out on how the government has been monitoring Americans.
Plus, what the Affordable Care Act will really mean for Americans.
And Sandra Bullock played her in The Blind Side, and now Leanne Tui plays herself on reality TV. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. Good evening. I'm Mark Martin.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. The number two Republican in the House says Congress wants more answers from the Obama administration after leaks about government surveillance programs.
The man behind those leaks revealed himself Sunday. He's 29-year-old Edward Snowden, a government contractor.
Snowden risked decades behind bars by leaking the information. Heather Sells has more in tonight's top story.
Even if you're not doing anything wrong, you're being watched and recorded.
During an interview with the Guardian newspaper, Edward Snowden said he witnessed government surveillance of innocent Americans while working as an NSA contractor.
I, sitting at my desk, certainly had the authorities to wiretap anyone, from you or your accountant to a federal judge to even the president if I had a personal email.
He has exposed two secret U.S. programs, one that collects the phone records of Americans and one that taps into U.S. companies to monitor overseas emails. The president says that Congress authorized the programs and that a secret court oversees them. The director of national intelligence says they do not target U.S. citizens. But Snowden says the programs are ripe for abuse and wants the public to know.
When you are subverting the power of government, that's a fundamentally dangerous thing to democracy.
But the government says Snowden is dangerous, and the Justice Department has launched a criminal investigation.
It's dangerous to our national security, and it violates the oath of which that person took. I absolutely think they should be prosecuted.
For now, Snowden has taken refuge in Hong Kong, where he faces possible extradition and years in prison.
You can't come forward against the world's most powerful intelligence agencies and be completely free from risk, because they're such powerful adversaries that no one can meaningfully oppose them.
Heather Sells, CBN News.
Wow. Supporters of Snowden are already asking the White House to pardon him for any crimes he may have committed, calling him a national hero. Tens of thousands have already signed an online petition.
A new report suggests the State Department may have covered up many kinds of illegal behavior. CBS News has uncovered a memo that cites 8 specific examples of misconduct, including allegations that officials were involved in sexual assaults, underground drug rings, and engaged prostitutes. Other allegations include reports of investigators being told to stop probing certain cases involving high-ranking State Department officials or ambassadors.
Oregon could become a magnet state for sex trafficking. According to anti-trafficking advocates, an Oregon bill will make buying sex with children a misdemeanor rather than a felony. 43 states currently make such a crime a felony. And anti-trafficking advocates fear a lesser penalty in Oregon will make it a trafficking destination. The bill's supporters say a felony is too harsh a punishment for those who inadvertently hire a child prostitute. The Oregon House could vote on the bill this week.
The number of homeschooled children in this country has increased by 75% since 1999. A report found in Education News is more proof that a growing number of parents are rejecting public schools. Researchers also say the number of primary-aged homeschool kids is growing 7 times faster than public school kids. Dr. Brian Ray of the National Home Education Research Institute says the increase is partly because the large number of children homeschooled in the 1990s are now homeschooling their own children. Currently, 4% of all school-aged children are educated at home.
Standard & Poor's rating services boosts its outlook for U.S. government debt. S&P says one reason is stable government spending levels. The credit rating service also says the economy has started to improve and is expected to continue on that trend. S&P changed its outlook from negative to stable. That means it's not as likely to downgrade the country's debt in the near future. S&P downgraded the U.S. government's long-term credit rating back in 2011.
Joining us now by Skype is Bill Frezza. He's a fellow at the Competitive Enterprise Institute and a Boston-based venture capitalist. Bill, break it down for us. For the average American, what does it mean for the credit rating to be upgraded?
Well, right now it means theater. Let's not forget the S&P ratings agency is being sued by the Justice Department. In addition, in a commercial litigation, McGraw Hill shareholders sought refunds for buying the stock back when the market collapsed. And a federal judge ruled that claims of objectivity and independence on the part of S&P were nothing but commercial puffery. Those claims were then used back in the Justice Department suit to claim that there was no basis for fraud, and in fact, there's no reason that we should believe these ratings.
The S&P cites an improving economy as a reason for the stable rating. Do you think the economy is improving?
If you look carefully at those numbers, you'll see that the labor participation rate is the lowest that it's been in 30 years. If you take the U3 unemployment rate and adjust it for labor participation, the actual unemployment rate is more like 11.3%. The stock market is certainly up because cash has no place else to go seeking return. So we're all enjoying at this point a shared illusion, hoping that reality follows behind it and people feel better and start spending. And right now, that's just a dream.
Bill, do you think Americans can breathe a sigh of relief and say the economic crisis is over, or can we expect more trouble ahead?
They can try the same sigh of relief that the Greeks have tried six or seven times. We've got nothing but trouble ahead, not only because of the monetary situation, but let's not forget the fiscal situation is still not being addressed. Social Security still is in trouble. Medicare is still in trouble. And now we have Obamacare coming down the road, which is not only going to have a huge impact on the economy, but you're going to see companies cutting payroll and cutting hours to avoid tripping the thresholds under which Obamacare is enforced.
The FBI has removed material that may be offensive to Muslims from its anti-terror training guidelines. A report from Judicial Watch shows materials linking the Muslim Brotherhood to terrorism or profiling terrorists as young male immigrants of Middle Eastern appearance are now gone. The Bureau calls such references unsuitable in the current political context. An independent group of experts on the subject reviewed the FBI's training curricula on counterterrorism, and they recommended the removal of presentations and curricula on Islam from FBI offices around the country.
North and South Korea officials met Sunday for a set of mid-level talks. The 17 hours of negotiations set the stage for higher-level meetings planned for Wednesday in Seoul. Now, these will be the highest-level talks between the North and the South in 6 years. The two sides have not yet agreed on a detailed agenda, but it's expected they'll discuss resuming operations at a jointly run factory park just north of the border and reuniting families separated during the war between the countries. The North's nuclear program will not be on the table, but still analysts say this is a significant step forward in relations between the two sides.
It was a violent few days in Afghanistan. A Polish soldier was killed in a roadside bombing this morning. That after Taliban insurgents launched an early morning attack near Afghanistan's main airport. Apparently, their target was NATO's airport headquarters. No civilians were killed, but hours of fighting left some of the Taliban attackers dead. And over the weekend, three American troops were killed in another attack. This recent violence has some questioning Afghanistan's security, as most foreign troops are set to withdraw next year.
A top Israeli official warns Iran is planning on building more than just a nuclear bomb. It wants to build an arsenal of nuclear weapons. Israel's Strategic Affairs Minister Yuval Steinitz told reporters in Jerusalem Iran wants to be able to eventually produce dozens of nuclear bombs a year.
We are speaking about an historical game changer. It's going to change the world. It's going to create a dangerous new world, totally different than today. It's going to have terrible, dramatic effect, not just on the Middle East and Israel, but also in Europe and the United States and beyond.
Pray for Israel. Steinitz says that while international sanctions against Iran are significant, the pressure the Western world is applying on Iran is not enough to make it abandon its goals of a nuclear arsenal.
The Swedish government has decided not to deport an Iranian Christian facing possible prison and torture in Iran. Riza Jabari was given permanent residency today by Sweden's Migration Board. The Swedish government had previously ordered Jabari to be deported despite his Christian testimony. Jabari's pastor says CBN's story about Jabari's situation changed the political climate for Christian refugees seeking asylum in Sweden.
What an answer to prayer. Well, coming up, we talk to Republican Senator Marco Rubio about his plan for health care in America.
Hello? Is this thing on? Hey, kids, do you love games? And do you love discovering things? Yeah! Well, do you?
Yeah! Then you're gonna love this. It's the new free Superbook Kids Bible app. You can play games, watch videos, find answers to your questions, and a whole lot more. The new Superbook Kids Bible app. Free downloads available on iTunes now.
Do you love fluffy cheese omelets, scrumptious baked apple desserts, savory French onion soup, melt-in-your-mouth chocolate souffle? Now you can make delicious gourmet food in minutes right in your microwave with StoneWave, the new microwave cooking miracle. Look, slice an apple, add cinnamon, sugar, and butter, and cook for 3 minutes in the microwave. It smells like homemade apple pie. Top with ice cream for a delectable dessert. Watch this. Core a sweet onion, add butter in a bouillon cube, pop it in the microwave for 4 minutes, and you won't believe the heavenly aroma. Cut it up for tasty toppings or a French onion soup bursting with flavor. The secret is the specially designed chimney that allows steam to escape while the custom dome circulates heat evenly, infusing flavor into food. Best of all, the ceramic surface is non-stick. No need for butter, fats, or oil. So it's the best way ever to make eggs. Simply place it in the microwave for 1 minute for a perfect fluffy omelet. Then just cover for a few seconds and look, it melts like magic. This microwave fits 4 StoneWaves, so you can make custom omelets in the microwave for the whole family. Poached eggs are great, but what a pain to make. Just pop an egg into StoneWave, and in just 1 minute, you've got a smooth, velvety, perfect poached egg. It's all right here in the StoneWave recipe book. All recipes in 5 minutes or less. So quick and easy, anyone can cook like a pro. You can even make a chocolate souffle just like the restaurants in only 5 minutes for just 50 cents. And yes, right in your microwave. So decadently delicious, you'll be amazed. You get the amazing StoneWave, made of ceramic stoneware with a special hollow handle that stays cool enough to hold. Plus all the recipes and incredible value for just $10. But call now and you can double your order. That's 2 for the price of 1. Call or click now and find out about free shipping.
Call 1-800-287-0762. But hurry, and you can get a special offer second StoneWave with all of today's orders. Call 1-800-287-0762. That's 1-800-287-0762. Call now.
Senator Marco Rubio tells CBN News he has a plan to get rid of Obamacare. It would involve passing a constitutional amendment banning any law that taxes Americans who don't buy a good or service. The new health care law does just that. And Rubio sat down with CBN's David Brody to explain why that's a problem.
Under the ruling the Supreme Court had, if tomorrow the federal government decided every American must have a smartphone, and if you don't, we're going to tax you for not having a smartphone, they could do that under the logic of this ruling. So obviously healthcare is a much bigger issue. So we are basically filing a constitutional amendment which says that you can't do that, that the government cannot compel Americans to buy a service or a good by punishing them for not doing it.
It's called the Right to Refuse Amendment. Rubio believes it will gain support when Americans start to realize how bad Obamacare is. And for more of David's exclusive interview with Rubio, you can check out his blog, The Brody File, and you can find that at cbnnews.com. Well, even though the health care law is set to take effect next year, nearly half of Americans don't even know it exists.
Unbelievable. Jennifer Wishon looks at what we can expect.
It's supposed to create jobs, provide health insurance for all Americans who want it, and save money. Instead, the Affordable Care Act, for many Americans, has already become a source of heartburn.
This is legislation that was 2,500 pages long, now 20,000 pages of legislation.
That's 17,500 pages of new regulations written by bureaucrats on top of an already complex law passed by Congress. and for employers who have no choice but to understand the nitty-gritty in order to make decisions for their companies, the task is overwhelming.
For example, there is the employer mandate, the requirement that businesses with 50 or more full-time equivalent employees provide health insurance or pay penalties. That was a 3.5-page provision that got turned into a 144-page regulation with 44 definitions.
One study predicts Obamacare will put more than 3 million jobs in jeopardy. For now, confusion and uncertainty about the law is stifling economic growth.
So there's a lot of heartburn right now and a lot of nervousness about what exactly the increased costs will mean for their bottom line.
President Obama maintains that Americans who like their insurance plan can keep it, but that's not turning out to be the case. According to a study of 11,000 plans on the individual market, less than 2% comply with Obamacare. That means 98% of plans must change, or the people using them must find new plans. And the Congressional Budget Office now estimates Obamacare will result in 7 million Americans being dropped from their employers' health plans and forced into new health exchanges set up by the law. It's true more Americans will have health insurance under Obamacare, but that will lead to greater demands on the healthcare system. And therein lies another problem.
We know that the government's own chief actuary says that about 15% of hospitals will close as a result of this because they're no longer viable.
Still, even after all 20,000 pages of regulations are implemented, not all Americans will be insured. CBO estimates by the year 2023, 30 million Americans still won't have insurance. And by that time, America will have spent nearly $2 trillion implementing the law.
We're spending a lot of money in helping relatively few people. In many ways, it probably would have been simpler and cheaper just to give everybody money to buy insurance.
Obamacare gives extraordinary discretion to the Secretary of Health. In fact, some 1,000 times, the law gives her power to create definitions and regulations. And that's why the number of pages in the law keeps on growing.
The law is so complex, some wonder if it can be implemented in January. Secretary Sebelius says it will. But many others doubt it. Even some Democrats worry it will be tough to get Obamacare to work and fear it could become a political liability for them in next year's elections. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Washington.
Up next, how a new TV show is helping families dealing with foster care.
If you have Medicare and have a chronic breathing condition, you can take your medication using an inhaler. Or this, a portable nebulizer from Med for Home. Independent studies have shown a nebulizer may be more effective and easier to use than just an inhaler. Impressive. It's like getting hospital quality treatment at home. So call Med for Home today to find out more. Med for Home is a specialty pharmacy that's here to help you however they can. They'll deal with your doctor, the paperwork, even ship for free. And their pharmacists and respiratory therapists are available 24/7. What's more, your nebulizer and medications may even be covered by your Part B benefits. For a better treatment at a much better price, call Med for Home now to learn how a portable nebulizer can help you start breathing better today. For more information, call 1-800-210-5821.
In 2008, my husband Gary departed for heaven. I was still grieving. And then to find out I had cancer, I began praying, God, how do I do this? Where do I do this? Cancer Treatment Centers of America was the place. Dr. Neelam outlined a plan that would take care of my mind and my body, and she prayed with me.
For Bible-believing Christians, we're able to pray with them in a much deeper way as they begin to really rely upon their faith.
At Cancer Treatment Centers of America, we believe in the power of faith and prayer as indispensable allies in the fight against complex and advanced stage cancer.
I'm back in Telluride on the mountain skiing. I feel strong and healthy.
Advanced medicine and technology.
And I am a survivor.
The warm embrace of the spirit and the power of prayer.
These are happy tears.
Please go to cancercenter.com/faith. Appointments available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Care that never quits.
Well, you might remember Leanne Toohey. She first stepped into the spotlight in the blockbuster film The Blind Side. Her family adopted a homeless teen who grew up to become an NFL star.
That player is Michael Orr, who helped the Baltimore Ravens win the Super Bowl. And now his mom leads a mission to turn foster homes into forever families.
In tonight's Focus Report, Ephraim Graham talks to Leanne about her new TV series, Family Edition.
The show is not my idea at all.
Leanne Toohey is a classy, no-nonsense ball of energy who doesn't hold her tongue.
I told someone very well-known this weekend, I said, I'm not sure who you think you are, but you're not very important. You cook. And so you need to realize that you're just a cook. And move on. And I mean, you know, and they're a well-known cook. But I mean, I was just incensed at the way they were treating someone.
Daddy's been gone 5 years, Elaine. Make matters worse, you were at the funeral.
Actress Sandra Bullock brought that big personality to the big screen in The Blind Side and won an Academy Award. It's a real-life Cinderella story. The Toohey family adopts a homeless 17-year-old who grows up to play for the Baltimore Ravens and even wins a Super Bowl. It all began on a cold Thanksgiving in 2003 when the family drives by Michael Orr walking on a Memphis street and decides to turn around.
Do you have any place to stay tonight? Don't you dare lie to me.
The fact that we did turn around, it changed our lives. It's really a love story. And, you know, I hope that the love story continues with family after family after family, because there are Michael Orrs in every city in this country, and all they need is someone to love them. And there's a lot of people with a lot of worth and a lot of value, and they just need an opportunity.
Leanne and her family are working to deliver opportunities to more families.
Team Toohey has one more little surprise for you.
With an inspirational reality series called Family Edition.
We're one of these that unless what we do makes a difference, we really don't want to play in that sandbox. And we've been offered every TV show you can imagine. You name it, we've been offered it. As a family, individually, they've wanted us to race, jump, hop, skip, surprise. I mean, everything you can think of. And that's just not who we are.
Leanne calls the show a perfect fit for her family and the work it does with the Making It Happen Foundation. In each episode, the Toohey family works to help families on the verge of adopting one or more of their foster children.
That I love you and I'm ready to be adopted by you both.
Oh. When you go into a family that is really just stretched to as tight as possible financially, just every way you can imagine, you would like to do something for them, that you leave a footprint that you were here and that, you know, we believe in you and we think what you're doing is right. So every episode thus far, we have tried to do something for the family to encourage them, to uplift them, to let them know that, man, you are doing the right thing. You know, you're the hero. You're the one making a difference in this child's life.
That's Toohey's message to the Jackson family in this episode.
I feel like I'm in prison. You got razor wire up there. Really?
Shadon and Jeffrey have two children, but still open their home to seven young siblings in California's foster care system. They were abandoned and left in a motel.
Shadon and Jeffrey are two of the most amazing individuals I've ever met. I just, every night when I lay my head on the pillow, I say thank you, God, for Shadon and Jeffrey Jackson, because they have stepped up and made a difference. There's this mother in L.A., and I'm not going to lie. If I meet her, it's potentially I could do bodily harm to her. You know, and she's just continues to birth these children. She's 26 years old. And she will do it again. And they cannot take another child in. The last two kids she had, she walked out of the hospital and looked at the lady at the front desk and said, you know who to call. Like, it was her laundry or her dry cleaning. It's a human being.
Leanne Toohey is quick to point out the foster care picture can be painful and frustrating. At any given time, there are at least 400,000 children in the system waiting for a permanent home.
There is no one walking the streets that had it any tougher than my son. Nobody. He was in 20-plus foster homes. He was one of 13 kids. I mean, it was as bad can get. And if someone like him, when you invest time and you love them, becomes so wildly successful, can you imagine who falls through the cracks that doesn't get help? And that keeps you up at night.
Toohey says foster care and adoption are significant issues in America, but they are manageable. And she hopes her series will inspire people to get involved.
Somebody has to be the voice of the kids. Do we think that God bestowed that message on us? A little bit. He uses simple people to tell stories. And he used our family, who were just simple, everyday, ordinary people, to tell a story. You know, look, not everyone can go out and adopt a 6'6", 350-pound African-American young man. You know, he eats a lot harder to find clothes for. There are issues. But we can all do something.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
Great story. Thanks, Ephraim. Well, up next, a top Facebook executive and best-selling author challenges graduates.
Do you love fluffy cheese omelets, scrumptious baked apple desserts, savory French onion soup, melt-in-your-mouth chocolate souffle? Now you can make delicious gourmet food in minutes right in your microwave with StoneWave, the new microwave cooking miracle. Look, slice an apple, add cinnamon, sugar, and butter, and cook for 3 minutes in the microwave. It smells like homemade apple pie. Top with ice cream for a delectable dessert. Watch this. Core a sweet onion, add butter in a bouillon cube. Pop it in the microwave for 4 minutes, and you won't believe the heavenly aroma. Cut it up for tasty toppings or a French onion soup bursting with flavor. The secret is the specially designed chimney that allows steam to escape while the custom dome circulates heat evenly, infusing flavor into food. Best of all, the ceramic surface is non-stick. No need for butter, fats, or oil. So it's the best way ever to make eggs. Simply place it in the microwave for 1 minute for a perfect fluffy omelet. Then just cover for a few seconds and look, it melts like magic. This microwave fits 4 StoneWaves, so you can make custom omelets in the microwave for the whole family. Poached eggs are great, but what a pain to make. Just pop an egg into StoneWave, and in just 1 minute, you've got a smooth, velvety, perfect poached egg. It's all right here in the StoneWave recipe book. All recipes in 5 minutes or less. So quick and easy, anyone can cook like a pro. You can even make a chocolate souffle just like the restaurants in only 5 minutes for just 50 cents. And yes, right in your microwave. So decadently delicious, you'll be amazed. You get the amazing StoneWave, made of ceramic stoneware with a special hollow handle that stays cool enough to hold. Plus all the recipes and incredible value for just $10. But call now and you can double your order. That's 2 for the price of 1. Call or click now and find out about free shipping.
Call 1-800-287-0762, but hurry, and you can get a special offer second stone wave with all of today's orders. Call 1-800-287-0762. That's 1-800-287-0762. Call now.
And finally, Sheryl Sandberg is a wife and mother, but she's also a successful Facebook executive and a best-selling author.
Over the weekend, she took her message directly to high school graduates. Sandberg called on students today to be the lean-in generation, not fearing success and going after not only their small wishes, but also their big dreams.
Graduates, with my congratulations to you, ask yourselves, what would you do if you weren't afraid? Then lean in and go do it.
I would actually do a lot if I wasn't afraid. Raise my hand more in class or voice my opinion more, not be intimidated with other people.
Sandberg says she knows it can be hard to own your success, especially if it means everyone may not like you, but she hopes she can inspire a generation to do just that.
I love that. What would you do if you weren't afraid?
Yeah, that applies to Christians as well.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. We're supposed to be bold as a lion.
That's right.
I love it. Great advice.
Right. Yes.
Well, that's going to do it for this edition of NewsWatch.
Remember, you can email us your comments and questions at newswatch@cbn.com. Hope you'll join us next time.